ويلكم بيتر.
أحمد
فريد فروم ذا باتس.
Help me put this on, please.
What are you doing?
We're gonna go down here.
Saudi Arabia.
This is a story about Saudi people, not Saudi politics.
Today, we're going on a mega road trip through the mountains of the southwest corner of Saudi Arabia. I found some random windy road on Google Maps that looks interesting. And then down, down, down. So we're at 7,500 feet now, roughly 2,300 meters. Down to Jizan, which is on the Red Sea coast.
No.
No, okay. Good, yeah,
help me put this on, please.
How do I do?
Oh, yeah. That's what I didn't have the extra fold.
Thank you, brother.
Gutra ogal.
Habibi.
Habibi.
We go.
خلينا ورا ورا ورا. Now good.
Good.
Good, sir.
Yes, sir.
شكراً. شكراً.
Much better.
King House, okay. Shukran.
Let's not go there. Looks like a palace. There has to be some beautiful landscaping and vegetation in there. And I think this is, as far as temperatures go, the coolest part of the country. We're gonna go down here. There's a windy road. Where is it? There it is. I think that's the road, and then go down through this valley and out towards the Red Sea. This wood is so rugged, weathered, hard. Yeah, I don't think it comes as a surprise to anybody that Saudi Arabia is an arid, dry, rugged place. So just getting a little bit of greenery like this does absolute wonders for the mind, I'd say.
Salam.
One thing I don't get about so much of the world is the whole trash thing. Especially when there are all these trash cans around. It doesn't make any sense to me. There's a can right there. But that's how it goes. If your father threw the bottle on the ground, most likely you're gonna throw the bottle on the ground. That's how humanity works for the most part. Habits get passed on. You either learn from your parents and you emulate them, or you learn, you look at what they do and you do the exact opposite. This is called Rajal Heritage Village. If you want to be in a country where there are absolutely zero tourists, I don't think you can beat Saudi Arabia on that front. Shukran.
Shukran jazilan.
I'm from Yemen. It reminds me of that art area I went yesterday when there wasn't one person there. They're drinking the green cancer here. That stuff used to make my teeth hurt. I used to be addicted to Mountain Dew, which is terrible. It's like antifreeze.
Looks like people are living up here. This old village is empty. Some of the buildings, well, that one's been redone. Some of them are broken. Falling apart. Others have been redone. My boy Ali is setting things up here, setting it right. It's getting really hot out, so this is the way to do it, right? Shukran.
Of one.
Of one. We're kissing, we're blowing kisses.
Before, in the past, we don't have any police officers. Just the head of tribe, we call it Sheikh, if anyone in the tribe do something wrong, steal something, beat someone, he will catch him.
Right.
It depends about what he's done.
And the Saudi government took control of this town 100 years ago, right?
No, about 89
years ago.
89 years ago,
okay.
And when the Ottoman Empire fall, they can't pay him. By the money.
Right.
They give him the guns.
Mm-hmm.
And the bullet is coming here.
Right.
That's the city.
Yeah.
Actually, it used to be fort, military fort.
Gotcha.
Guard. All the village here.
Yeah.
Watch it by the guns.
Do that again, that was cool.
Watch this. All those doors are shops to sell a lot of things.
How long ago were people living here?
50 years.
50 years ago?
They're moving to Abha.
Abha, that's where I came from. It's interesting, these new city lights in here.
Watch your heads.
Okay. How old is this town?
About now 900 years old.
900 years old.
Yeah. You can see the houses up. Right. You fed from the snakes.
Huh?
You fed from the snakes. We have a lot of snakes.
You have a lot of snakes?
No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
People live in these now?
No.
No. Okay.
The old place. You can see that this one. Oops.
Oh, cool. Cool.
We have Arabian tiger. And a lot of birds here.
Baboons. Do you like the baboons?
No, it's vicious.
They're vicious, aren't they? Yeah, people think they're cute. They think they're cute and
no,
nice.
No. Dangerous for the kids,
for everybody.
If the monkeys, if they found you alone, they will attack you.
They'll rip your face
off. You must watch it. Very old.
Yeah, it's mud floor.
Yeah.
Look at that.
They're making those floors by mix the mud and manure.
Okay.
Put together.
Man.
Man, those bats, bro.
You're afraid from bats?
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of bats, dude.
No problem. It's hard. Come. See you with the old guest room.
Fuck, they're flying around. Someone just buzzed your head, bro. Let me.
Peter, here is Fred from the bats.
Man, I admit it.
This is traditional guest room. You can see the bats here.
Are you blessing me? What's going on?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I'm welcoming you.
This is that really hard wood from up on the mountain, right?
Merhaba. Welcome. This is an old guest room.
Wow.
Yeah. It's made by women.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Every single woman in this village, if anyone built a house or something.
Mm-hmm. This was here?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, look at the art. Oh. How many years ago?
40 years.
I 40 think. Years ago.
Yeah.
So what's happening? People are moving out.
To search jobs.
Right.
And schools and college.
Sure.
Used to be like living room.
Uh-huh.
For one fucking bad. There
we go.
Yeah, okay. So where are you taking me?
My house. It's up in there.
I'm not a fan of bats. I like your road here. It's quite steep.
Actually, that's cop from a gift from Peter. Thank you, Peter.
Well, I live in Ukraine, bro, and you always have to, if you enter someone's home, you have to bring a gift. It's a very cool tradition. Nice place.
Yeah,
this is cool.
Or tea?
Tea's great. This is your brother.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Okay, what's your name?
Yeah. Ahmed.
Ahmed.
Yes.
Peter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Thank you. What's in here?
My house.
This is your house. I thought that was your house.
Sorry about
that. No problem. This is your place. You live alone or your brother lives in here too?
No. Actually, we have a new house.
Oh, okay. Okay.
He likes to stay here. Rojal.
Yeah. It was a center point for trade, right?
Yeah.
From Djibouti, you were saying?
Yeah. Djibouti and Sudan and Ethiopia and from Yemen.
I love the look of the Arabic language. So beautiful.
Actually, not. This is not Arabic.
What language. Is it?
Othmanic language, this one. This one. This one?
Can you read this?
No.
You don't care?
No.
Yeah, me neither.
Not Arabic.
Okay. Oh, that's a nice view. Great view. Wow.
And look at here.
What kind of snake?
Amazing, huh?
Yeah, wow. This is how you make your coffee?
Yeah. Yes. For the guest.
I was lucky to meet Ibrahim Ali Fati right when I was leaving, because there were no English speakers. And he gave me the type of tour that I like. I think you guys like that too, right? Going into different zones, different areas.
You feel adventurous. Bats, huh?
Shukran al
Arab Diafa.
Al Diafa.
This one, Mahadda, Marka, Farash.
Habibi, ya basha. Mishmish.
Better.
You were saying a wedding here cost how much?
About
$55,000.
$1,000.
So it's it's difficult.
I can't marry you because I love that. You must take me to Ukraine and marriage two women, because in our traditional, you must have four. And actually, the Ukrainian girls.
You like?
Blonde and skin, like flower. Say hi to me, to a Ukrainian girl.
Our traditional
Arabic traditional. That's a nice smoke.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Gives you a little
three times. You must.
Three times?
Yeah. You must do it three times.
Welcome, Peter.
Good. Like this.
Yeah. Face out, your face out.
Yeah.
Okay. From India, instant. Oud instant.
It's relaxing.
Yeah.
Instant. No, this is full. Okay, take it. Hold this. Okay.
Shukran. That oud that I just smoked was like marijuana. Like a very light hit. Sort of like what marijuana used to be before it got all scientific and super powerful. At least from my experiences in California recently. Assalamu alaikum. Okay? Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, what hot? Uh-huh.
Rice, yes.
Very black.
From India.
Nice to meet you.
Where are we going? Toilets, right? Toilet, okay. You know this stuff?
What is it?
Huh? No. Burn it. Fire. Yeah, really good. Abdul Saman is from Kerala, India.
India.
One of the nicer parts of the country. A lot of Indians here, huh?
Hey, Indians.
Many Indians, yeah. The toilet's not in the restaurant, it's down here, right? Okay. Here?
No.
Quite a mission for the toilet. Mercedes, nice Mercedes truck.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, toilet. Okay, fantastic. Yeah. Proper feast.
Pepsi?
Pepsi, no. Water's fine. This looks like a traditional Saudi meal. Saudis, let us know in the comments what this is. It looks good. Mm-hmm. I scored. Fuck yeah. So good. Mm. I needed this so bad. I've been doing that fast food bullshit. Just because I couldn't find places easily.
Thank you.
Shukran. Cool thing about the open road, like a day like today, you have that skeleton route, but you don't know what you're gonna go into, you don't know what to expect, you don't know what you're gonna eat, who you're gonna meet, what you're gonna see. Love this stuff. And so the theme running through the day is friendly people, cool people, hospitality. So you know when people say the curse of knowledge? And what I mean by that is
when you know something, you think it's common knowledge. In Saudi Arabia, to me, the first day didn't know a thing. Nothing. Zero. I mean, except from what I heard from the outside, right? But as far as like how it felt on the ground, no understanding. Now, what is it? Day 5. Acclimated to it. And so, the curse of knowledge is, you know, once you've done it and experienced it, you think it's just, you know, it's normal shit. So I don't even know right now at this point in time if this even looks out of place, this even looks that much different, because I'm in the moment, I'm here, if this makes any sense at all. But you know what I'm talking about, like when you speak, when you know something, when you learn something, and they're like, oh yeah, I know that now, and then it just becomes common. Saudi Arabia is not there yet, for sure, like on the macro, no way. This place is so complex, this place is so mixed up. I mean, I've had conversations that I couldn't bring the camera out, right? But I've heard everything from people telling me, you know, alcohol will be legal in a couple years, or a year, I think I was told, to someone I just met saying he thinks it's terrible that women are allowed to drive now. And this is because he says he respects women and wants to look after them. Spectrum is massive here. It's all over the place. There are a lot of social codes here, and I don't really know them all, to be honest. People seem to like this, though. They get a kick out of it. Now, obviously, I'm not fitting in with this. I don't look like anyone from here. But more than that, it's cool to play with identity. It's cool to wear, let's just call it a different costume, right? Identify myself differently. Be in a completely different culture and country. Operate outside of my language. Or let's just call it get by outside of my language. It really adds that, like, that adventure. I think it's not for everyone, right? But that adventure we all long for, you can find it in this type of travel. You can find it in the unknown. The predictable shit is great for many things, and we all want safety and security. Fact. But zagging the other way from time to time, where I find this is a balance. I got my rental car, know where I'm going, got a hotel room tonight, roads are good. It's not that crazy. But the interactions throughout the day along the route, they're surprises. They're magical. I didn't have one bad experience today. I really feel that the world is universal in that sense. Is if you just go in with an open mind and open heart, people are warm. That's it, guys. End of an epic Saudi road trip here in Jizan on the Red Sea coast. Gonna try to get out to an island tomorrow. I heard there's an island out here to explore, so I'm gonna try to make that happen. So thanks for coming along. I'm really excited for this. This is amazing. I think it costs like $45 a night and air conditioning. It is very, very hot outside. So until tomorrow. Peace.
Arabian tiger. And a lot of birds here.
Baboons. Do you like the baboons?
No. It's vicious.